What? You don't read 4 books at once? And you call yourself a book lover? Okay, hang on, let me just... If it's not clear by the title of this video, I'm a fan of reading more than one book at once. It wasn't always this way though, because I used to think that this was a ridiculous and impossible idea. How can you possibly read more than one book and not get lost and forget stuff? How do you do it and not forget what you've read? And most importantly, how do you read more than one book if I really struggle to just read one? You might be thinking all of this too, in which case in this video I'm going to be debunking and answering all of those questions so you can give reading more than one book at a time a go, because life's too short not to try, hey? Oh, and also I'll be going through why reading more than one book at a time is so damn good for you. Okay, let's not beat around the bush. This is a very real and legitimate reason to not try reading more than one book at once. After all, if you can't even finish one book, then adding an extra book to your reading schedule makes no sense at all. I used to feel exactly the same, but when I added an extra book, I found that I ended up reading more, not less. This is because instead of just sticking to one book, I'd branched out into two. So during my lunch breaks, I could read a brain-heavy non-fiction book, and after work in the evening, I could read a relaxing fiction book. You're simply not going to be in the right mood or frame of mind to read that one exact book all the time. So by giving yourself the extra option, you're not limiting yourself to one book that you might take ages to finish reading. A little break in between a more serious book with one you read to relax is so good for your mental health. Plus, by reading more than one book at a time, believe it or not, you'll reduce your to-be-read list so much quicker. Instead of focusing on one book and not picking up another until you finish that one book, which could take a long time, especially if it's hard to read or you're not enjoying it or you have to be in a certain mood to read it. You're giving yourself options, which will help you get through more than one book so much faster. Rather than forcing yourself to finish a hard read before moving to the next one, starting something new will break things up. And you might find the hard read is even more satisfying once you've finished it. If you're worried you won't finish a book you're reading because you keep switching to different books, then let me ask you this. Are you really enjoying the first book? If you're enjoying a book, then you'll want to come back to it. It's as simple as that. If you're not, then there's no wonder you're struggling to finish it. This is why reading more than one book is so beneficial, because it helps you see through the reading fog and help you realize whether you're actually enjoying a book or not. If you're reading just one book right now and are struggling, you're probably taking an absolute age just to finish that one book because you're not enjoying it. However, if you're reading more than one book, you can switch from the hard book to one you'll enjoy more. If you come back to the original and it still doesn't work, you're free to drop it and move on because you've got something to compare it to. You simply don't need to keep reading books you don't like. But if you need a little pep talk on that one, I'll leave a video link in the description all about it. But let's think about this in a different way. Imagine you're watching a series on Netflix. If you're anything like me, you switch between different series all the time depending on how you feel. If you watched one and it's 10 times better than the one you watched previously, you might want to go back to try again, but if you don't like it, you might just stop watching. You have permission to do this with books too. You simply don't have to keep reading books you don't like. If you're thinking, okay, I realistically cannot fit reading more than one book into my life, you're not getting it, Gina. I get it. I honestly do. But if you're watching this video, then you likely are curious about reading more than one book at once, either that or you want to fit more reading into your life. If this is the case, then let me suggest this to you. By reading more than one book at once, you can take advantage of all the different reading mediums that exist out there. For example, I read fiction on my phone in bed, but I'll read a non-fiction physical book in my living room. Similarly, if you go to the gym, you could listen to an audiobook while there and read a different book when you get home. These books can simply slot into your average daily routine, and you can even customize them depending on the mood, the genre, the thing you're doing, anything. Going on a journey? Pick an epic adventure novel to listen to while in the car or on the train. Working out in the gym? Pick a motivational nonfiction book to get your mind working with your body. Relaxing after a hard day at work? Pick a lighthearted novel to suit your specific tastes. You could pick books for seasons, holidays, events, moods, and more. By reading or listening to more than one book at once, you'll find new ways to slot reading into your life. And hey, you can have fun while you're at it, because isn't that what reading is all about? Reading is incredibly good for you. It goes beyond entertainment and education. It stimulates your mind, improves concentration, reduces stress, anxiety, improves reading and writing skills. I don't need to tell you all this, you know it. You get to enjoy all of these benefits when you read multiple books at the same time. Have a fiction book ready to spark your imagination, and have a non-fiction book ready to help you improve things in your life at the same time. Or simply mix two completely different fiction books depending on how you're feeling. The options are endless. Nobody has to read multiple books at the same time, nor do you have to do it all the time, even if you enjoy it. But if you've not tried it, it's honestly worth giving a go. You never know, you might be a convert like me. So I'd love to know from you. Do you read multiple books at once or not? If you do, how many books are you reading right now? I'd love to know, so leave me a comment. And I will see you next Thursday for another video.